You have all of these huge movies out, right? Are you noticing a change in people around you? Are you getting recognised more?
No, I think I've kind of changed a lot. I look different and different. I just keep on stumbling through this sentence until I get somewhere.
Yeah.
Have you guys got anything like that from your childhood which you still keep with you?
Yes, I have my bunny. I got given my bunny when I was born, and I still sleep with my bunny, and I'm 27. So bunny's really old, but it's like...
I bet bunny doesn't smell too good.
I keep bunny a wash every so often, but... Yeah, no, it's really weird, and I used to get really embarrassed. If someone, like, came over, I'd, like, hide Bunny under a pillow. That's and be I like, ah, I'm, yeah, but...
Look, anything like Bunny?
No, I'm a normal, I'm a well-adjusted grown-up.
Yeah, adult.
Yeah, I'm a grown-up now, so no, I don't have dolls in the bed.
One of those faces people don't really recognise. I had a really amazing thing happen, which I was in a movie called Anna Karenina.
Yes.
In which I had a beard and, like, long hair and stuff. And I was on a flight... And I helped this old lady get her suitcase up, and she was sitting beside me, and she was so lovely. And they handed her iPads because they didn't have any screens in the plane. And she put on Anna Karenina, and I helped her put up her bag. And I thought, I'm going to be the hero here. She's going to be like this beautiful man, yeah. You know, because I'm so beautiful. And then so she started watching it, and then I was waiting for it to get to my bit. I was like looking over, and then it got to my bit, and she watched the scene, and she paused it, and she looked over at me, and I was like. And she goes, could you get me back to the home screen? This is terrible.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
And I had to hit my own face and be like, back to home screen. And then.
Yes, I can. Yeah.
The world is your home.
The world.
My home's Ireland.
Home's Ireland. Just one clear cut answer. Yeah, just Ireland. Yeah.
Ireland.
Donald keeps it very simple.
I know. I'm like, and the one time I went to the Philippines, that felt
really... I spent a short summer in Brazil. I suppose in a way that's home.
So, would you rather get to do as many takes as you'd like or have to nail it in one?
Oh. No, we'll get to do as many takes as you like, and then you treat it as though you have to nail it in one.
Would you rather watch your least favorite performance over and over or never get to see your best?
Of mine.
Of yours.
Oh. Never get to see my best, I'm fine with that.
I even knew the ending of the film and I cried when I watched it. Like, loud cry too, I was like, doing those ones.
Did you really?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, that's good.
Did you not?
No, I just didn't think it was very good.
Mm. You just, no. I thought it was brilliant.
We really dropped the ball on this one.
We should start this interview again.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
When you say goodbye to kind of a co-worker at the end of a long shoot, it's always quite sad, but is it particularly
sad?
That's true, and you didn't have to bring it up.
No, I've told you about the
sandwich. But it was, I felt, I know, yeah.
Let's all share here.
It was. I'm about to share something really personal. I don't know why I would do that. No. Sorry, I'm just going to put a full stop in my own aborted sentence.
Would you rather have no movies released for 5 years or 10 in 1 year?
Do I have to promote them?
Yes. That's the whole
no
the
movies
question.
For 5 years.
That's totally fair.
Yeah, yeah. You would just be promoting all the time and you'd never get to work. So I'd rather be working.
Donal has a number of party tricks which would which he could sometimes perform.
Never
between,
when Will was around. What are these? What are these party
your
tricks?
Arm farts.
Oh yeah.
And you're really flexible.
Yeah, yeah, really flexible as well. Hang on a second.
Yeah. They're amazing. Look at this. It's incredible.
Pretty good.
Sorry, good.
Anyway.
I've never heard anything like it.
So that was mostly what we did in between takes. Believe me, 3 months is a long time when all you've got are armpit first.
Never got old for me.
Yeah.
Never got old.
And the winner is... Brendan Gleeson for Suffragette. Sadly, Brendan can't be here as he's away filming. So to collect his award, here is Sarah Gavron.
Yeah, yeah,
Brendan
yeah.
Told me.
My dad told me that I should accept it if he beat me at this. And now there's been a massive misunderstanding and it's the worst fucking thing that's ever happened. Okay, he even... Thank you, Alicia, by the way, for calling someone else's name. That's great. Here's the note that my dad... So, I mean, yeah, he sent it just in case he won because he obviously knew he was going to. Okay. Thank you, Biffa. I'm raging. I can't be there. Love to the other nominees, all of whom I've had the pleasure and privilege to work with. That's nice. This is a profession that draws wonderful human beings to itself. It's been an honor to work on Suffragette, particularly with Sarah, who will it be? Gavron. Jessica Parker will be furious. A beacon of intelligence and sensitivity. I particularly loved the rehearsal with herself and Abby. Thanks hugely to Kerry Mulligan, my partner in crime, so to speak, and to the others of this wonderful cast. To paraphrase George Formby, my mind's not on my work at all when they're breaking windows. The joke didn't even work. He made me read a joke that didn't even work. Okay. Is that sexist, he then said? Maybe. I only said it to add to my son's pain. And then he said, votes for women, which actually is important. And thank you for not giving it to me and to my fucking dad. Yeah!
It's so easy to go, horrid.
Horrid.
Yeah. It doesn't look easy when you do it.
horrid.
Looks quite hard, the way, yeah.
Happy was my favourite word to say.
I'd watch a movie with you and puppies and kittens.
Oh, listen, I mean, I wouldn't. It'd end up being my worst one, as we said. But no, yeah, that would be good. I love, you should see the family dog. He's amazing. Seamus. Looks like he's got a wig. He's got little curls on top of his head for some reason. I don't know why. We finished with Will. I was so sad to say goodbye to him, and Marco just kept laughing. So that was how we differ, I think.
I was laughing, to be clear, I was laughing at Domhnall. I wasn't laughing at Will going out into the dangerous world.
No, yeah, yeah. Good luck with that, buddy. Yeah, yeah. No, it was more at me, which was nice.
Like, why are you crying?
And the winner is Tom Hardy, the legend.
Tom is busy filming at the moment. So, to collect the award, please welcome again the wonderful Domhnall Gleeson.
Well, I want to thank my mam. Yeah, I think it's clear what's happened. Tom has decided to make a fool of me. That's fine. I have nothing to do with this film whatsoever. I worked with him on The Revenant. He made my life a living hell, and here we are again, so it's all good. Okay. He says, that's fucking awesome. Will you let them know I really didn't expect to win that, although he wrote an email, so you never know. Because the competition is so fierce and all of them deserve the win, to be fair, which I do agree with. Amazing performances. And that'll mean a lot coming from someone who was nominated for Best Supporting Actor. You're welcome, Colin, Michael, winner. Thank you for the support. This is Tom again, and recognition. It's a massive deal and really much appreciated. Thanks to you and you, that might be me, and Brian and Emily and all of the team at Working Title and all the crew on set and behind the scenes, Lindy and Mick and Jack, that's really for them, as I didn't do much. It was all in the script, mate. Mate. And working with super talented people involved. I'll give this to Tom.
Because you couldn't laugh on the day, because like Will's there and I got to pretend to be a grown-up.
Yeah.
But like now...
He was taking the acting so seriously that actually it made me take it more seriously. But I did less goofing around because I was like, oh no, I don't want him to think that we're not serious about this.
And exactly. I'd be like, come on, Will! Yeah. He'd be like, well, do you mind?
I'm like, we're trying to do the arm farts again. Will's like, I'm getting into the moment. We're like, I'm sorry, Will.
Would you rather have to sign on to a project without reading the script or without knowing who you're going to work with?
Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Without reading the script. No. No, I can't. I'm not doing that one.
He wasn't like a jaded child actor who's like, no. Ugh, been here.
Here we go. I'm doing one more and then that's lunch. Will, come on.
And smoking Will, why the dimples. Accent?
Yeah, Will. Yeah, yeah. His accent is perfect in the film.
Suicide Squad 2, what can we expect from that one?
That's true. I truly don't know. I haven't seen a script. But, I'm curious to find out.
That was the worst answer.
It's true.
You didn't even make it entertaining. You didn't even put a little spin on it. I don't know.
I don't know.
Get out.
What I meant to say is...
As soon as I hear Star Wars, what I want to say is get out.
Yeah.
But I don't.
No.
You just said get out, basically. Sorry about this.
I have nothing. I just don't know. That's all. But I'm sure it'll be amazing.
Will you be in it?
I hope so.
And that's good. Okay.
I'm sure. I hope. Right, well, now you made me doubt whether I'm in it or not.
That would have been an exclusive.
Yeah,
especially
yeah,
if you're in it now and I'm not.
I'm playing Harley Quinn.
Right, I'm going to get out now.
Yeah,
thank you very much. Yeah, get out.
Thanks for that.
Cheers. Thank you.